Hello and welcome to another edition of Crosse Technologies Tech Talk, a show designed around answering your questions quickly and accurately. I'm Greg Piesel, and today we will be taking you through the basic setup to your new color wind speed weather station. So, let's go! Before we get started, if you are viewing this video on YouTube, I want to direct your attention to the description below. Here you will find the times and descriptions to each of the steps that will be covered. Simply by clicking the blue highlighted time, you will jump ahead to that spot in this video. These work great if you're looking to find information on something specific. I should note, however, that if you're viewing this on a mobile device such as a phone or tablet, you will need to drag the red playhead to these times listed. But otherwise, just sit back and learn as we take you through each step of the setup process. Step 1. Make sure channel 1 is selected on the outdoor TH or thermal hygro sensor, and then insert two new AA batteries according to polarity. Step 2. Insert two new C batteries into the wind sensor by grabbing the vented portion and turning counterclockwise to remove the cover. After the batteries are installed, this then gets replaced by carefully realigning the battery cover with the vented portion of the sensor and turning clockwise. Step 3. Insert the 5-volt power cord into an outlet, and then into the back of the weather station itself. We do also recommend inserting three new AA batteries, according to polarity, into the back of the weather station as well. These are optional, however, they will help the station maintain its time and weather information during power loss. Step 4. Check your outdoor sensor's connection. The outdoor temperature, humidity, and wind information should show up within the first 3 minutes. This means the dashes will turn into numbers on screen. And after which, we recommend keeping the sensors within 5 to 10 feet from the station for at least 15 minutes before moving them to their outside locations. This helps the station and sensors sync properly and ensures a strong connection. For step 5, we will be taking you through your settings menu. To enter the settings menu, press and hold the set button for about 3 seconds, or until the beep on-off setting begins flashing on screen. Once in the settings menu, you will use the plus or minus button to adjust the values, and the set button again to confirm your adjustments and move to the next item in the settings menu. I should also point out that if you'd like to exit the settings menu at any time, simply press and release the light button on top of the unit. This will save any changes you make and bring you back to the main screen. So here's the order in which the settings menu will follow. First is the beep on-off setting. The default is on, meaning you will hear a beep for every button push. To change this to off, you will need to press and release either the plus or minus button. To confirm this selection, press and release the set button. This then brings us to the atomic time on-off setting. It is important to note that if I set this to off, the settings menu will then skip over item 3, the time zone setting, and item 4, the daylight savings time option, leading me straight to item 5. We will talk more about the specific atomic time details later on in this chapter, but for now, I will leave this on the default on setting by once again pressing and releasing the set button to confirm my selection. Because I set the atomic time setting to on, the next feature then will allow me to choose my time zone. Using the plus or minus button to cycle through, these are abbreviated where EST stands for Eastern Time, CST Central Time, MST Mountain Time, PST Pacific Time, AKT Alaskan Time, HAT Hawaiian Time, and AST Atlantic Time. I am located in Wisconsin, so I'll select CST for Central Time. But please make sure to choose the proper time zone for where you are located. To confirm my selection, I will once again press and release the set button. Setting 4 is pretty straightforward and allows us to choose whether or not we want to follow daylight savings time. The default setting is on, but should you wish to shut it off, simply use the plus or minus button to switch between the two. For me, I would like it on and will confirm this selection by pressing and releasing the set button. This then brings us to setting 5, where we can select between 12 and 24 hour time. I will go with 12-hour and make this my selection by pressing and releasing the set button. Next will be the hour setting. It's about 3:30 p.m. here, so using the plus button, I will move the hour to 3, making sure the AM symbol turns off and the PM symbol turns on. Now that I'm at 3 p.m., I will press and release the set button again to jump to the minute selection. Here, I will press and hold the plus button now to make the numbers climb rapidly. This also works in the opposite direction with the minus button. Once I reach 30 minutes, I will press and release the set button again to move to the year setting. It's currently 2017, so I'll confirm this with the press and release of the set button. Next, I move to the month option. Today is March 9th, so I will move the month to MAR for March, confirm this, and then move the following date number here to the 9th. Confirming this once again with the set button. The 11th setting here is the Fahrenheit or Celsius temperature reading option. The default is Fahrenheit, but once again you can easily change this with the plus or minus button. I will, however, stick with Fahrenheit and make this my selection by pressing the set button. And finally, the last setting option lets you choose how you would like your wind speed displayed, in miles per hour or kilometers per hour. I'll stick with the default miles per hour and make this my selection with one final press and release of the set button. This will bring us back to the main screen and keep all of the changes we have made. Now, to finish up what I was saying earlier about this station's atomic time feature, when set to on, like we just did in the settings menu, this station will search for the atomic time signal at the coordinated universal times of 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And if there is no WWVB reception, the station will search for the atomic time signal every 2 hours until the WWVB time is received. The atomic time signal icon will flash while searching, and the tower icon will remain solid on screen when it is connected. After the reception is found, the station will only search for the atomic time signal after midnight, keeping it connected permanently. Of course, you can have the station perform a manual search for the WWVB time signal as well. To do this, from the normal time display, simply press and release the set button. But please be sure to have selected the correct time zone from the list in the settings menu. When the atomic time signal is received, the station will set to the time zone you selected there. Now for step 6, let's mount these wireless outdoor sensors, starting with the smaller temp and humidity sensor. To mount the sensor, use the hole at the top to either hang it from the back using a nail, or insert one mounting screw through the front. You will want to try and place it on a north-facing wall or in any well-shaded area to avoid high temperature readings caused by the sun. Make sure also that it is mounted vertically to allow for moisture to drain out properly. Now let's mount the larger wind speed sensor. For the most accurate wind speed readings, you will want to mount this sensor in an open area and as the highest object for 50 feet in all directions. Attach it to your own mounting pole with screws through the holes in the cylindrical opening on the bottom. This pole should be no larger than 1 3/16 inch in diameter. This is also where you would connect the included mounting bracket for installation onto a flat surface. The construction of this bracket allows you to mount the sensor from the bottom or from the side. Simply attach it to a flat surface with 4 screws through the holes on the bottom. But most importantly, make sure the sensor is secure and mounted level for accurate wind speed readings. The maximum wireless transmission range from each of your outdoor sensors to your station is around 330 feet of open air. This does not account for walls, floors, windows, or any other objects that may cause interference. Because of this, we do recommend temporarily putting your sensors in the locations you'd like them to be, testing them for a few days to make sure they stay connected, before mounting them permanently. But now, before we go, we also wanted to show you how to connect additional sensors to your station, and view their data on its separate channels. This station can accommodate up to 2 additional thermohygro sensors, to be used on channels 2 and 3. These are great for monitoring temperature and humidity from different areas around your home. To set these up, first remove the battery cover from each add-on sensor. Next, set the first add-on sensor to channel 2, and insert 2 AA batteries. If you're adding a third sensor, set that one to channel 3, and also insert 2 AA batteries. Then, on the station, press and hold the temp button for 3 seconds. This will have it start a search for new sensors. After this, press and release the TX button on each add-on sensor to have them transmit a signal. When connected, the temperature and humidity data from each of the selected channels will appear. To cycle through the channels, press and release the minus button. You'll see these indicated by the channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3 icon with each press of the minus button. But after the connection is established, which should happen within a minute or two, feel free to reconnect the battery covers. It's here where we recommend keeping the sensors within 5 to 10 feet of your wind station for at least 15 minutes. This allows all the parts to establish a strong connection with each other before the sensors get moved elsewhere. But there you go, you have just gone through the hardest part of setting up and using your new weather station. Don't forget to consult the instruction manual provided in the description below should you have further questions regarding details not covered in this video. But also feel free to comment below with any issues or specific questions you may have. We are here to help you. In the meantime, we hope you enjoy your new color wind speed weather station. I'm Greg Piesel, here for La Crosse Technologies Tech Talk. We'll see you next time.